Yo, what's up, y'all? It's your boy DC the Truth.
I really hate I can't create the content the way I want to. Just being so busy right now, but Dlai, just come on out the closet. Let's get into it. Now, I know I may be a couple days late, but I seen Billy Sorrells with live on IG Live, and I'm about to play the clip in a minute, and I come back and give my commentary on there. But before I play the clip, I just want to say this man has been adamant about putting you guys' business out there. I guess he said it isn't just the what you did, so to speak. You two, I mean, as far as the swinging, it's the, I don't know, to him, like I said in my last live stream, you know, with that swinging culture, so to speak, it can be very confusing, because when you swinging, it gets to be murky waters when you go to swing without your partners involved. So, therefore, you know, it can become a whole train wreck. But I've done my talking. Let's hear what Billy Sorrells had to say.
Huge mistakes in my marriage. I tried valiantly to love you unconditionally. And guess what? I still love you even though you tried to fucking murder me. Let's get over the fact that you fucking my friends. We were swingers. I don't care about that shit. I'm just mad that my friend, Dlai, didn't say, hey, there's no Frank Ocean here, okay? I don't kiss men in the mouth, so that's not it for me. If you want to know how I like to torture soul, get ready for it. Again, and if you have any questions about, so if you don't want to suck my dick, buy the sweatshirt. Now, the level of petty, let me tell you something, because I need you motherfuckers to know something. I'm tired of being fucking nice guy Billy Sorrells, or Peaches. Yes, that was me. I shattered the fucking internet with shit black girls say. Let me shout out my girl, Lena Waithe, who fucking took a risk on me when nobody wanted to take a risk on me.
All right. We back at scheduled programming. Again, I want to apologize. That was my own edit of the live stream. By all means, it was not my internet connection. That's just what, I don't know what Billy Sorrells had going on with his internet. But the pausing and freezing, that was not on me. But anyway, so like I said before, clearly, he's basically calling Dlai out. And Dlai is, I don't know, he's one of them guys that I had plenty of comments from a lot of females. They say, you know, he's one of those manipulators. The way he gonna chalk things up is like, hey, they'll forget about it the next day, which is like, hey, by all, this is what I don't understand. Really, when it comes down to it, there's by all, there, I mean, when it comes to the LGBTQRST, when it comes to that community, I don't understand why people still trying to keep this down low persona. If that's how you go, that's how you go. There's people are welcome in this community with open arms. And Dlai is out there. You haven't really addressed that situation directly, or am I missing something? If I'm missing something, y'all please feel free to, y'all see the link in the description, hit me with the inquiries where I'm missing something. And, you know, I would gladly correct myself. But Dlai, like, come on, bro. The cat's out the bag. For somebody really to go this far to basically self-sabotage them and shoot themselves, Cheddar Bob their own selves, Billy ain't got nothing to lose. You, on the other hand, just deflecting the situation. It's looking real bad. And I know people say, you know, if you don't say nothing at all, but hell, Dlai, you said something. You just didn't address the core situation. I don't get it. I really don't get it. You just want to keep hiding your lifestyle in the closet, man. It is what it is. You know, I don't know what the big secret is. Why not go ahead and address it? It's either yay or nay. People gonna believe what side of the story they want to believe anyway. But, you know, if you just refuse to address the situation and don't address the core question, then people are automatically gonna question you, Dlai. So come on out. Y'all, it's your boy DC the Truth, and I'm out of here. For real.
Honestly, I don't know who the fuck to trust. Is he my friend or my foe? I'm a ex bro. Yeah, she give me that claim as well. I remember back when I was younger, I was happy. Nowadays, feel like no one understands me. I'm good at all this silly, I'm bought, damn it. Baby, see, I look texty.